shells. So first postulate of Bohr's model, he said that atom is made up of three subatomic particles. First, electron, which are negatively charged. Second, protons, which are positively charged. And third, neutrons, which are neutral. In which protons and neutrons are staying in the nucleus, but electrons are staying around the nucleus, they revolve around the nucleus. Secondly, that number of electrons and number of protons are equal in number, and that's why atom is electrically neutral. Third point, he said that there are so many energy levels or shells in which electrons rotate, and they can be calculated as according n is equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. Or the alphabetic manner K, L, M, N. K is the shell which is nearest to the nucleus, then L, then M, then N, and so on. And there is energy difference in these chains. The shell means the K shell which is nearest to the nucleus having minimum energy. And as we move in the higher shells, the energy increases. Now, the number of electrons fit according to 2n square formula, and according to this, the first shell, K shell, contain only 2 electrons. Then L, 8 electrons, N can accommodate maximum 18 electrons, and N can accommodate 32 electrons. Now, the point comes, why atom is stable? So, Bohr said that these energy shells having fixed amount of energy, and if any electron is revolving in that particular shell, it will not lose energy or it will not gain energy, and that's why it revolves around this nucleus, this shell again and again without destroying. Now last, there is only two situations where electrons leave this shell. First, when it absorbs energy, and when it absorbs energy, it jumps in a higher shell.